once lived a boy with a penchant for magic. His story is one that's both joyful and tragic. It started one night as he paced in his room, when that strange bud called chance came into full bloom. A party for dinner the boy's parents would host, and as guests would raise up their glasses to toast, a visiting daughter who went up to play would find herself altered in a most peculiar way. The amateur wizard, a novice warlock, the girl who has no longer bright eyes and clean frock, but a slobbering beast, an error most foul. And who could reverse this? A true friend. A pink pal. 'Twas chance yet again that led Pink to the boy, in the form of a salesman. Strong pitch, dab of coy. The children were desperate and needed Pink's aid, but the risk would be great, and the cat was afraid. The boy had no choice. Coercion was needed. He cast a cruel spell that Pink's book be deleted. The frantic pink cat knew not what to do, said the warlock to the cat, "Helping us will help you." And so Pink would begin to search across the world wide for the girl's needed cure and a salve for his hide. I know what you're wondering. You're sharp, I can tell. How that amateur wizard proved to cast a true spell without dragging the young hopeful's name through the mud. I confess to have helped him. Yours truly. Strange blood.
I had a terrible dream. Wannabe magicians? Slobbering wombats? Where am I?
Yeah, it was such a dream.
What happened? Pink Panther, that's me, drops out of the super spy business and becomes a traveling salesman. That much I remember. I guess this must be one of the houses I stumbled into to try to sell the Book of Knowledge. Maybe I had to use the bathroom. I hope I went.
Yeah, so, greetings fellow Earthlings, welcome to Pink Panther in Hokus Pokus Pink. This is a game that I've played before as a child, and as far as the mansion is concerned, I do remember most sections of it. Although, I don't really know what goes on beyond that. I have completed this game quite a few times. First off, we had downstairs this guy wants some money, some tips to be let in. I'll just show you guys that. Yeah, we don't have any tips. So we'll have to go down. We can't go back in there because that door is locked. Apparently, these games were a huge part of nostalgia for a lot of people. There's nothing over here except for just these, rooms that we can get inside. Comparing to Pink Panther's Passport to Peril, I would say that this game is far better made. At least that's just how I feel like. This guy will give us the first thing we need.
Yes, preventative dentistry is where it's all going. I say, take the darn teeth out while they're still good and healthy. Saves you tons of money and safeguards your gums. Put those good teeth on the shelf for special occasions. And for everyday use, try Shinobar. These are the teeth of the future, gentlemen. No flossing or brushing required. Mine here are the first set ever to be made entirely out of Shinobar. Allow me to demonstrate. Shinobar is a high-gloss flame-retardant material that smells mildly like peanuts and has no problem going through the dishwasher. Shinobar bounces, it's stain-resistant and virtually non-sticking.
Yeah, so that was his speech, and
doesn't seem to belong to anyone in particular.
That's how we get inside the damn door that's locked right now.
What are you?
I'm a Pink Panther.
Are you a pet? Maybe my daughter wants you.
I'm not for sale.
I'll pay $250,000.
I'll need plenty of food and water. You can pick me up on your way out.
Man, this guy changes his opinion very quickly, doesn't he?
I don't believe we've met. The name's Flip Loose Liver. I see you're without champagne.
Yes, quite intentionally. Wouldn't want to wind up with a loose liver, Flip. You go ahead.
I mean, I can sort of tell that this guy's jaundiced because of the way his skin is all yellow. And I'm guessing that's why he's called Loose Liver. Don't know what Flip is all about, though. We come across some of the housewives over here. And yeah, that's about the extent
of... I think I'm starting to notice an interior design theme here. Is it a motif? I think it's a motif.
It's more than a motif, it's the entire personality of this house. So yeah.
Are you the florist? You're late. The champagne delivery? You're early. Wait a minute, I recognize you now. You're that lowly sales cat who came peddling books.
Ms. Periwinkle, maybe he's here to bid on the Star's Bite collection.
Nonsense, Midge. You haven't a clue. He's a commoner. I can smell it on him. It's putrid.
Did you say Star's Bite collection?
I suppose you'll need a tip. Take this. Thank you for stopping by to inconvenience us. Farewell, adieu, bon voyage. Show yourself out. Come, ladies. There's still time to tour my shoe museum before supper.
Rich folk, I swear. Alright, nothing else. Wait. I saw something there. Should have taken a peek before I went out. But oh well. It's fine.
That must be the Star's Bite collection. I really shouldn't, but I'm just so darn curious. So let me get this straight. This guy is selling a bunch of rotten old famous people's teeth? Cool.
At least they're famous people's teeth, though, is what I'll say. Could have easily been, like, you know, just the teeth that he plucked out because of his preventative dentistry. Up the stairs we go. And we give this guy the tips. That came out of the madam's tits. And he will let us
happy
in.
Happy trails.
I wonder how much these waiters can make in a day. Oh, they really went overboard with the entire tooth thing, didn't they? Like this... It's adorned with toothbrushes.
Of going through other people's medicine cabinets, Emily Post writes, and I'm paraphrasing, unless you are a fictitious pink character appearing in a CD-ROM game, do not do it. Luckily...
A good lesson there for you kids.
Smile, Traforder. Support your smile.
It makes it difficult to close your mouth more like, but okay. Whatever floats your boat. Oh yeah, I forgot about this part. And he's gonna stay in there until you bring him out. I mean, we can sort of enjoy the music here, I guess. That should be long enough for your cat.
I can't do it with you listening. Forget it.
All right, back out we go. Nothing else here. Nothing else of value, that is. As far as I recall. Now that we've given this guy a tip, he won't ask for one again.
Locked! But I need to get back in there to help those crazy kids!
So, you do recall it not being a dream. That's the Book of Knowledge, by the way. I think that's how we travel between places. Or maybe it's like the BTA from the first game.
The boy! The horrible monster! I thought it was all a nightmare, but...
You again. Have you changed your mind? Are you ready to talk turkey? If you don't help me transform Violet back into a little girl, then she's...
Definitely missing her prom, that's for sure. Don't cry, Violet. The prom is overrated.
I'm not crying because of the prom. I'm crying because I don't want to be a plain little girl.
Well, whoa. You're not. You're a big hairy.
I didn't want to be a wombat either. I wanted to be an immortal, magical, ninja, princess mermaid.
And I wanted to be a traveling salesman, but then little Houdini here erased my book.
I told you, if you help me transform Violet into an... immortal, magical, ninja, princess, mermaid.
Then I'll lift the curse off your book and you can go back to your dumb traveling sales job.
If you can't reverse her spell, why should I believe you could reverse the spell you cast on my book?
I can't do it alone. I need your help.
The answers lie with strange blood.
Strange blood, huh?
When you find and retrieve the right ingredients to reverse this miscast spell, we'll sprinkle them into my cauldron. When you find and retrieve the right...
It sort of felt like it got cut off there, so that's why I played it again. I recall this being an object that we could interact with.
Deep in the dark and enchanted woods, you know, behind my house, there lives a warlock named Strangeblood, who alone lives quiet as a mouse. He spins black magic and casts wicked spells. Some even claim that the future he tells. The townspeople disowned him and cast him aside. But when he slips away to his lab, I do ride. I pinch powder from potions and at his research steal looks. And every so often, I borrow his books.
You stole all these things?
I borrowed them. It's Strangeblood's books that got us into this mess. It's Strangeblood's books that can get us out.
Why do you go into his lab, Nathan, if he caught you?
He's evil, Violet. I must master his own sorcery so that one day I can destroy him and save Golden Moles from his villainous clutches.
How do you know he's evil?
Everybody says so.
As simple a reasoning as any, I suppose.
You've just gotta help us undo this spell, please!
Okay, why can't I pick up any of this stuff? I thought the apple... I could pick up the apple.
Looks like this Strangeblood's had a hard life.
Yes, yes he has.
When you find and
anything else?
What are you waiting for? You should be out looking for clues or potions or something to reverse this spell. Strangeblood's lab is the obvious place to begin.
Right, then I'm just trying to pick up the apple, but I suppose I'll only be able to pick it up later. It looks like something that you can pick up. Anyhow, let's go to Strangeblood. I'm just going to check this area for anything else. Does not seem to be anything else there. Stuff is pretty easy to spot. Stuff that you can interact
with. As Vincent Van Gogh said, I am not an adventurer by choice, but by fate. And so, I'm off to see Uncle Strangeblood now. Wish me luck.
I never knew Van Gogh had an Uncle Strangeblood. What an eerie coincidence.
That actually looks like one of those pull-down bars. A pink panther that's in front of the moon. I always loved these aesthetics as a child. Anyhow. That is how we go back again.
Every cool night at the stroke of just 8, he walks in the woods for 1 hour straight.
If I can hear that, how come he can't?
Who's there? Was that you, Wind? I'll be back in an hour, Spot.
Spot, huh? That might be the name of his dog, I suppose.
How bad could he be? He's got a pet named Spot. Every cold night at the stroke of just 8, he walks in the woods for 1 hour straight. I can be in and out in 1 hour, no problem.
Let's hope that is the case. I feel like that guy just went out because he heard the boy say that.
Here, Spot. Spot, are you here? Here, Spot. Spot, are you here?
Yeah, I'm here.
A little Spot.
You're just a black spot.
Black hole, actually, but being called hole wouldn't be very endearing.
Wow, you're a real black hole. I've never met one of you before.
No one has, except Strange Blood.
All right, then. Let's grab that book.
That's the old man's spell reversal manual. It contains the magic ingredients needed to reverse a bad spell.
That is exactly what I'm looking for. But every cold night at the stroke of just 8, you walk in the woods for 1 hour straight. What happened?
It was unusually warm out this evening.
Probably should have talked to Spot before picking the book up. But over.
Oh no! The spell reversal manual!
That's alright. I can still read the pages.
How do you change a wombat into an immortal magical ninja princess mermaid?
Let's see here. To make an immortal mermaid, you'll need to find me, the only thing living in the saltiest sea. To make a magic princess, you'll need a princely laugh. Specifically, the hugest one that has a chilly past.
What about the ninja part?
Doesn't say. Personally, I would improvise. Can't hide. Good help.
That's what you think.
Where are we going now? Where are we going?
Oh, yeah, I forgot about all of this. Okay, I'm certain that you don't actually pick up anything from one point of the game and take it to the other point, but I do like the glitch effects though. This, I think, was the salt sea. The very salty sea, I forgot which one it was. The Dead Sea, I think? I don't know what that is. Let's start with the Ice Age, because that's what I used to do as a child. Not the Ice Age, rather, but Siberia.
What's that?
A page from the Book of Knowledge.
My missing pages.
That's impressive.
Yes, it belongs to no one.
All right, there's a clown here in Siberia, but
hey, Yazit's milk pouch. It must have fallen off his neck. The milk tastes kind of funny, though.
You look like a fish out of water.
This is my first time in Siberia.
Funny, I don't remember asking.
That guy just walked back. Oh damn, there's a woolly mammoth in there. It's alive.
He's huge! He has a chilly past. I know I need that crazy mammoth in my life, but I'm just not sure how to get it. Why so sad, clown?
Why you think? Look at me. Clown without circus. Rebel without cause. Cookie nor milk. This is chicken soup, nor noodles.
You lost me.
I couldn't perform in Moscow Circus anymore because smile wasn't big enough, they say. Nobody liked the sad fat clown, they say. Get rid of him, they say. How do you think the sad fat clown felt then?
Sad and fat, I'm guessing?
100% right! I came to Siberia to freeze myself to death.
What happened?
No.
I dressed too warmly.
Well, you can make me laugh. Anyhow, you need some support for your smile, you say? Like this right here?
I've got something that I think will really help you.
Oleg Karskov.
Mr. Karskov, this here is a newfangled item called a smile supporter. It could be of great help to a clown in your sad state.
Am I smiling right now? Am I smiling right now? This feels really funny, but I think I am smiling right now!
Yes, sir, yes, you are.
I'm in great pain, but oh, I'm happy! Truly happy! Smiling like real clown again! I can do anything real clown can do! Except walking.
I'm glad to have been able to help.
Let me know if I can ever repay you. I'll do anything except walk. I can't do that right now.
Hey, sounds like a nasty little post-arctic drip. You might want to get that looked at. Hey, sounds like a...
Yeah, we need to somehow get that thing. I do remember it being of use in the journey. This, by the way, is a different thing, I do believe. Apparently not. I think we need to unfreeze it somehow. Let's head there. I don't think there is any other place we can go. Spawning inside a lake in Siberia. Talk about bad luck. And there's a woman trimming her huge ass fingernails over there. Oh boy. I want to go touring in Siberia one day. Nothing there.
Well, now there's something I like to see. An elderly woman sitting in the freezing cold, hacking apart her disgusting yellow toenails. Warms the cockles of my heart.
Watch your filthy mouth! Yasit! Yasit! Come home, Yasit! Come home!
Said the bear.
Should have named him Snoopy.
Named who Snoopy?
My missing reindeer, Yasit! Yasit!
Quiet! Grandma Tonga, I can't hear the TV!
Hello! I am trying to get a little shut-eye here. I am in hibernation, yet I can't get to sleep. Do not disturb me, comprende? No moleste, senor!
That is food supply hut. We built it nice and high so the bears would not get to it.
That's an illusion bears can climb.
These toenails look strangely aerodynamic.
Ah, yes, that's what we cut the icicle off with. Let's head inside. I think we need to help him with the TV or something.
Oh, hello. I'm Chuki.
That's quite a swim you've got.
Well, I only wanted to try to tune in my favorite show, Blarney. It's about a big beige-colored walrus that sings little rhymes to children. And it all seems fun and innocent at first, but then he slowly brainwashes them to act aggressively and beg their parents for sugared foods. I can't miss it! I want candy!
Oh, damn.
Oh.
There was a time in my life when I would have gotten in trouble for that.
I don't let anyone touch those. Back off!
Do you always keep a fire burning inside your tent?
Always. In the winter, it keeps us warm. In the summer, it keeps the mosquitoes away.
What about spring and fall?
We make s'mores.
Does it get hot enough in Siberia during the summers for mosquitoes to actually be there? I don't think so.
Wow, in Siberia, it even snows on TV.
It must be my satellite dish out back. I made it myself. Would you mind fooling with it? Are you going back out there to help me? Aw, thanks.
I recall requiring that videotape.
Oh! I can see Blarney's feet! Try moving around with it a bit! Hey! What happened?
I think we needed to keep it somewhere. Maybe up there?
Now, Chooky!
This is much better! I see Blarney's blubbery body! Can you get the dish up any higher?
Yeah, we probably needed to do something with that.
A freshly fallen mound. Hey, look! Snow Panther!
Wait, were we supposed to do something with that? I recall we were supposed to. I don't think that's gonna help, but I guess that's what we used to do with that.
I always wanted a twin brother. I'll call him Nip.
So that is where you keep the antenna.
I'm missing Blarney!
Not the toenail, no. But this, yes.
I see Blarney's blubbery body! Can you get the dish up any higher?
Oh, well, we'll check it out nonetheless. How about here, then? Oh, there. Alright, then. One thing that I like about this game is that it lets you make mistakes. How about some goat milk for you? Maybe that'll pacify you. So I got my goat milk back as well. That's nice. Oh well, now where do we place the antenna? I think we need to get something else to, you know, that'll enable us to climb all the way up there, or at least pacify the bear first. Alright, back there we go. I think this is the reindeer that we need to get back to the woman.
That turned out to be a pretty handy tow.
Yazit, come with me.
Sorry, it's not reindeer hunting season.
Alright, there we go. We can now access the other side.
Say, nice weather we're having. It always worked in the past, but I guess I'll need a better icebreaker.
Yes, we still need to break that damn thing, don't we? Hmm. I do recall needing an icicle from here, but maybe that'll come later. The time for that, I mean.
Say, nice weather we're having. It always worked.
What about you, though? Can you do something for us then?
Oh, joyous day. Is it me? Or do the pine trees smell extra piney? This sky ever so much more sky-like than I remembered. Even the birds seem to be whistling my favorite concerto, if I'm not mistaken.
Can you do something for us, though? Apparently not. Oh, hey, there are more people here now. That's interesting. We can finally talk to this guy.
Are you using your whiskers?
Yes, why?
I am Golden Maul's top plastic surgeon, Dr. Imeki Yunu. This is my wife, Himeki Yunu. She is constructed entirely out of excess body parts my patients leave behind. Everyone in Golden Maul's has contributed to her fabrication. I thought you might like her to wear your whiskers.
I doubt anybody would be requiring that. Belt. I wonder why...
Never know when a black belt will come in handy.
You freeze that sort of strangely there, Kainzer, and there's this futuristic man here.
Oh, I'm Shaky Golden Pipes. Good to meet you. Every time I see a new face, I can't help but greet
you. Are you of any relation to Shoopy Golden Pipes? I'm his biggest fan. I have all his records.
Shoopy is my stepdad. I'm Shaky here, his son. My record just came out, and I'm sure that I'll sell some.
No doubt. No doubt. So, I guess that makes you the stepson of Soul.
Ha ha, that's right! Say it two times!
Stepson of Soul, stepson of Soul.
Say it once more!
I can't. I have stuff to do.
Hello, I'm Saltina Crackerbarrel, heiress to the Saltina Cracker fortune, therefore I'm very rich.
I see. What about the wife there?
Hello, are you using your whiskers?
Yes.
I am Gold.
Very exciting evening.
More exciting than you know.
I don't really fit in here.
That's not such a bad thing.
I've been trying to get into high society since the day I was born. But my name said it all. Midge Poorpenny.
Pleasure to meet you, Miss Poorpenny. So, how did you wind up here anyway?
Haven't you heard? I'm Midge Poorpenny. I'm the lotto winner. I'm a zillionaire. But money change everything. This crowd still doesn't accept me. That's why I want to purchase the whole entire Stars Bite collection. Then they'll know my taste is as good as theirs.
Sounds like a prudent plan.
Okay, this post
Perhaps
is fine.
Perhaps I should go check on the children.
Oh, no.
No, they're
no,
busy.
Absolutely
I mean,
not.
Fine.
And that's when I said to my little fluoride face, let's throw a gala event. It will be a wonderful opportunity for me to inadvertently draw attention to myself.
Having a fun time, kitty?
All right, nothing of value here except for the black belt. Specifically a black belt, though. Not what I intended to do, come on. I thought it looked like the mansion, the place that we were going to. I guess we need to come all the way here to do that, huh? Teeth, teeth, lots of teeth. Reminds you of that tooth fetish checklist from, what's the name of the anime? Speed Grapher, right. There was a guy with a tooth fetish there.